is late-breaking news from Eyewitness News 5.
Good afternoon. I'm Rachel Calderon. Texas authorities say they have found Oklahoma fugitive Charles Dyer. He was found in the Houston area, was taken into custody. He is wanted in Stevens County for missing a court date. He is accused of raping a six-year-old girl. Let's go live to Houston now for the latest on this investigation and what authorities there have to say.
Goodrich observed a suspect fitting the fugitive description at the intersection of Farmer and I believe it's where it turns into Mason Road. He detained the suspect, who gave a fictitious name at first and subsequently admitted that he was indeed fugitive Charles Dyer. He was taken into custody without incident and transported to Fort Bend County Jail. He will be extradited back to Oklahoma. This arrest is a result of an investigation that included multiple agencies in several states. Some of those include the FBI, Texas Rangers and Texas Highway Patrol, Texas Department of Criminal Justice, Police Department, Waller County Sheriff's Office, Wallace Police Department, and Stevens County Sheriff's Office in Oklahoma. It was due to the efforts of all these agencies involved that pressure was maintained on this individual that kept him from being able to rest during this process. He's been on the run in this area for about 5 days, living in the river or on the river. He's in pretty good shape considering what he's been enduring the last few days while we kept up the pressure on him. Any questions?
Could you tell us again where exactly he was found?
It's a 9700 block of Mason Road. It's actually near the Waterside subdivision off of FM or Highway 99 and Mason Road.
So he was basically camping out along the river?
So our understanding that he was living along the river at night or during the daytime and coming out at night.
Can you talk to us a little about several days or did he talk about that?
He said he hadn't eaten in the last 4 days.
Just to be sure, we're talking about the Brazos River?
Yes, Brazos River.
And is he talking to you, Chief? Is he giving you any information?
He is talking to some of the investigators. We're not really going to go into what all he's saying, but he is talking with some investigators.
Has he explained why he's in Texas?
No.
Do you have any intuition in that direction, any idea of why he would have ended up down in our area?
I don't have a clue as to what brought him to Texas.
When you were a deputy approaching about what he was, his reason to be.
I'm not sure if I follow your question.
When your deputy approached him, what was his motive? What did he say? I mean, I'm the person you're looking for?
When the deputy approached him, he ordered him to the ground at gunpoint, cuffed him, and then started talking to him. The guy gave him a fictitious name, and then they found some identification in his pocket that led the deputy to believe he was indeed the suspect, and he subsequently admitted, yes, that I am Charles Dyer, I'm the guy you're looking for.
And why was he suspicious? What was it about him that made it?
The citizen, that, like a lot of cases, the reason this guy's in custody, in addition to all the efforts by law enforcement, was a concerned citizen. He looked suspicious to that citizen in that his clothes were dirty, he looked like he'd been living outside, and he fit the basic description of the fugitive. And that's the same thing the deputy observed. I mean, he had a backpack, his clothes were dirty and muddy, he was carrying a water jug. He looked kind of out of place where he was.
Not the kind of thing they would see normally in waterside states.
No, it's a very nice upscale community.
And you were just listening in on the press conference held in Houston by sheriff's deputies as we heard from there. We know that, again, that Charles Dyer was wanted in Stevens County for missing a court date. He is accused of raping a six-year-old girl. He was on the run, really, for the last week and a half. And as you just heard, a concerned citizen helped lead authorities to spotting him. He had been living, as we had heard, for the last several days by the river and is said to be in good shape despite not eating for the last 4.5 days. We will have more on this developing story throughout the day and at 5 and 6 o'clock on Eyewitness News. You can always tune in on KOCO.com. For now, we'll send you back to regular programming.
This has been late-breaking news from Eyewitness News 5.